Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. Today in this tutorial we are discussing about a pattern program, that is how we can print stars in alphabetical Z shape. And this program is also similar to the previous pattern programs. So let's begin with the code. Okay, here is our output, and here we can see we want to print stars in different row and column, right? Here we can see row as well as column. So to print stars in rows and column, we are using nested for loop, that is for loop within the for loop. And in the nested for loop, there will be an outer for loop and inner for loop. Here in our program, the outer for loop will be the for loop for rows, and the inner for loop will be the for loop for column. That is nothing but first we'll write the for loop for row. Inside that we'll write the for loop for column. Okay. That's because here we'll print star like this. Okay. We'll check at row 0. We'll check for column 0, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, column 5. After printing this row, we'll go to the next row, that is row 1. And we'll check for column 0, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, column 5. Again, after printing this star, we'll go to the next line and we'll print stars in the next row. Okay, because of this, first we'll write the for loop for row. Inside that, we'll write the for loop for column. So here we can see this is the first for loop. This for loop is for row. Okay, and here row is the variable name. And here we are using range function. And inside this function, we need to mention start and end. That is how many rows you want in your program. So if you see our output, okay, here we are writing the for loop for row. So these are the rows. Here we can see we want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 row. Okay. And here index is start from 0. So we want row as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So here I'll mention range like this. I want row from 0, so 0 to 6. So this will give output as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, here 6 is excluded. So it will give output as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That here we can see. Okay. Okay, inside that for loop, we are taking the for loop for column. As I said, this is the inner for loop. And this for loop is to print stars in the column. And here call is the variable name. Here also we are using range function. And here I need to mention the number of column we want in our output. So here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want 6 column. Here also index start from 0. So here I'll write the same range, that is 0 to 6. So it will give output 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Next, inside this for loop, we are taking if else conditional statement. That is, here I want to print stars in some particular pattern. Here I want to print star in alphabetical Z shape. For that we need condition, that is in which row and column you want to print star, right? So we are using here if else conditional statement. And here after if keyword, I need to mention the condition, that is in which row and column you want to print star. Okay. So for that we need to see the output. Okay. First here we can see we want to print star here. Right. This is at row 0. We want to print star at row 0 in each column. That is column 0, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, column 5. Right. So I want star at row 0. So this is my first condition. So I'll check whether row is equal to 0. If it is true, then I want to print star. Next, we'll take logical OR operator. All right. Next, here we can see here we want to print these stars. This is at row 5, right? So I want to print star at row 5. So here my next condition is I'll check whether row is equal to 5. And here I use logical OR because here if any one of this condition is true, I want to print star. Whether row is equal to 0 or row equal to 5. If any one of this is true, I want to print star. That's why I took logical OR here. Okay, next I want to print these stars. And here we can see this star at column 4 and row 1. This is at column 3, row 2. This is at column 2 and row 3. This is at column 1 and row 4. And here we can see one thing. First, we want to print star at column 4 and row 1. That is this star. Okay. After that, I need to decrement the column value. That is, here we can see column 3. And increment row value. That is because here we can see row 2. To print this star. And to print this star, again, I need to decrement column value and increment row value. Okay. So, to print this star, what I'll do is, I'll take two variables I and j and I'll initialize initial row and column value to them. That is nothing but I'll take two variables and for row I'll take variable name as I and column I'll take variable name as j. Okay. And here I'll take I value as 1 first and j value is 4. Okay. So, I'll check whether row is equal to I and column is equal to j. I want to print star. So, it will print this star. Okay. After that, what I'll do is, I'll decrement j value. So, j value become 3 and increment I value. So, I value become 2. So, it will print this star. Again, I'll decrement j value. So, j value become 2 and I'll increment I value. So, I value become 3. So, it will print star here. Again, I'll decrement j value, so j value become 1 and increment I value, so I value become 4, so it will print star here. Okay, so I want these 4 star, so I'll use this method. Okay, so first I need to take two variables I and I'll initialize variable I as 1 and j with 4. Why? That's because here we can see initially column value is 4, I value is 1. Okay. Next, here I'll use colon. Here I'll take elif condition. And here I'll mention my condition, that is when row is equal to I and column is equal to j, I want to print star. So print. Okay, here I wrote this condition here, not after this, because here in this condition we'll increment row value and decrement column value. So if you write this condition here, we won't get the proper output. That's why we are taking elif and we are mentioning this condition. Okay, so for now, I value is 1 and j value is 4. So it will print star here. Okay. So, to print these 3 stars, I need to increment row value, that is I value. So, I is equal to I plus 1 and I'll decrement column value. So, j is equal to j minus 1. Okay, here my first condition is when row is equal to 0, I want to print star, or when row is equal to 5, I want to print star. So, if any one of this condition is true, control goes to the print function and it will print star. And here we can say end is equal to empty string. In the print function, by default end value will be slash n. Okay, but here we don't want that. Here after printing 1 star, I want next star immediately after that. I don't want any new line between them. If I didn't mention end is equal to empty string, after printing this star, control will go to the next line, so it will print output in the single line. But I don't want that. That's why here I change the end value to empty string. Okay. Next. So next condition is this. When row is equal to I and column is equal to j. And here I value is 1 and j value is 4. So it will print star here. And after that I'll increment row value and decrement column value. Here if this condition is true, it will skip elif part and else part. Okay. If this condition becomes false, then only control go to the elif and it will check this condition. If it is true, it will print star. If this is also false, then control goes to the else part and it will print space. That's nothing but here in some places we can see space, right? So in some row and column I want to print space. That's why we took this else part. And next here we can see print function inside the first for loop. That is the for loop for row. So inside this for loop we are taking print function. This is for new line. That is here we can see after printing star in one row, I want to go to the next line. Okay, we want new line for each row. That's why here I took print function. Okay, so now we are done with our code. So we need to save this and run this. So here we can see the output. And here if you want, you can change the number of rows and column value. Okay, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you next class. Till then, take care.